Loki is arguably the first solid, complex MCU villain that was actually praised instead of just jeered. With his new show coming soon, we wonder if he's still going to be the same villainous trickster we know, or if he might be cleaning up his act for the show. Let's see if there are any examples of Loki trying to do better. But before we disguise ourselves with a magical Asgardian illusion, subscribe to CBR and punch that bell to join our notification squad so you never miss any of our MCU videos in the future. Forming the Mighty Avengers. Following his death in the comic Ragnarok story, Loki was reborn. However, his body wasn't his familiar form, but the one of Sif. Sif was a warrior goddess from Asgard that fought alongside Thor, Loki, and the Warriors Three. Loki hijacked her body and, for a time, was doing just fine and dandy in this new getup. However, the Elder God Chthon arrived seeking to finish his earlier plan of dominating the Earth. Since his original plan of having an organic host body was foiled by Sorcerer Supreme Doctor Strange, he possessed Quicksilver to act out his plans. Still a woman, Loki disguised that body as Scarlet Witch and united a team of Hercules, Amadeus Cho, Stature, the Wasp, Vision, Jocasta, and US Agent. No one noticed this was Loki as Scarlet Witch until after Chthon was defeated and he released his possession over Quicksilver. Since Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch are twin mutants, he immediately wanted answers from his sister. But surprise, it wasn't. He didn't switch bodies until later when Sif almost dies, but this still counts in his favor. Don't fight the giants! Originally played up strictly as the jealous magical brother, we still see him with the ability to think for the good of the group. After the attack on Thor's crowning, frost giants invade Asgard in an attempt to retrieve their power source and treasure, the Casket of Ancient Winters. Thor rushes into a plan to travel to the home of the frost giants, Jotunheim, and deal with them on his own terms. Bringing along Loki, Sif, and the Warriors Three, they find themselves surrounded. Thor barks at them in only a way that Thor can while Loki takes in the situation. He knows they're definitely outnumbered, outpowered, and risks starting a war between the new nations. He causes Thor not to go from the start, and he's the one talking Thor down from a battle. He even speaks as the middleman for Thor so he doesn't spark a conflict between the two realms. That unfortunately doesn't last long for Loki, as Thor ultimately does cause a battle. It turns out Loki was doing this for his own personal evil reasons all along, but good on him for not getting the Warriors 3 hurt. Loki's text edit. Kull Borson is the Asgardian god of fear, former king, all-father, and brother to Odin. After he is all-father, he betrays Odin and his other brothers, causing a family battle. Odin seals his brother away for many years until Red Skull's daughter, Sin, frees him. He continues his plan in spreading fear throughout the Nine Realms by sending out different Hammers of the Worthy, seeking out those who are worthy of helping further his plans. Mainly, the hammer ends up in the hands of a lot of supervillains, but two of them end with a couple of heavy-hitter heroes, the Thing and the Hulk. It works for a while and Earth suffers. Thor even battles these versions of Hulk and the Thing. He reveals his heritage to Thor and the two begin battle. Things don't look great for Thor during this battle as Kull transforms himself into a giant serpent from mythology. Thor makes a hero sacrifice and dies defeating Kull. Now, this is a victory, but it turns out Loki made the victory possible by rewriting history and giving Thor a weakness to exploit. Love for Mother. Loki has a fair amount of complex feelings and thoughts when it comes to the concept of family. Odin found Loki as an infant on Jotunheim and brought the boy home. Loki only saw himself in Odin's eyes as the disgrace who could never truly be king because of his heritage. This set a deeper rift in their relationship with both Thor and Odin. However, in both Thor and Thor the Dark World, we see Loki show more of a compassionate side for their mother, Queen Frigga, the one who initially bonded with Loki by showing him magic. She is the only one willing to treat him with some humility after the events of the Avengers, as well as make his imprisonment a bit more bearable. He shuns her in impulse, but later mourns her as his true mother, though she is not. Her death in the Dark World helped Loki shed many of his malicious layers, and he began a lighter path in the MCU. So cheers to you, Frigga. Thor and Jane's escape. After his grand defeat in New York City on Earth by the Avengers, Loki was very much feeling the loss in Thor the Dark World. He was sentenced to life as a prisoner and was constantly shackled where he awaited his doom. The Dark World gives us the Aether, a red and black substance weapon that the Dark Elves planned on using to rule the Nine Realms during Convergence. We later know the Aether as the Reality Stone, capable of manipulating reality around it and the different forms it interacts with. Malekith, the leader of the Elves, leads an attack on Asgard for the Aether. Too difficult an escape for just Thor and Jane to make, there's one person who he knows they can ask for help. It's Loki! He, in his multiple adventures, found multiple ways in and out of Asgard that Heimdall couldn't even see. He offered to take Thor and Jane to Svartalfheim away from the current attack. Thor frees him, makes their way off the mainland, and crosses the water to the hidden exit out of Asgard. We get a nice brotherly moment out of the two of them where Thor promises to get revenge for their mother. Thor, Loki, and Hela. Thor and Loki thought they were the only two sons of Odin and known gods throughout the realm. However, they were most definitely wrong. Odin sired another child, a daughter who was most ruthless and even helped him in his conquerings. Making her appearance in Thor Ragnarok is Hela, the goddess of death. Odin used Hela, his true firstborn, as the leader of his armies that went out with him and helped him garner his reputation as a powerful warlord. After Thor exposes Loki as a fake Odin, they find the real Odin on Earth, and he tells them of Hela's return, and they're unsuccessful at dealing with it in the beginning. However, after finding the Hulk and one of the last Valkyries, Thor and Loki take another shot at saving their home together. After all of this, it's surprising Loki truly wants anything to do with Asgard. He can't be the true king due to his heritage, and he's technically a prisoner, but one can stand up for their city and country when it's all hands on deck, and Loki got such a cool fight sequence out of it. Asgardians versus Seth. In the Marvel Universe, as well as DC and other comic canons, pretty much all cultures and religious deities exist together. Egyptian god Seth warred with different gods of his pantheon. However, he didn't start causing real damage until he locked the gods away and absorbed their power for his own doing. After entertaining his own will for thousands of years, he finally comes in contact with Thor, causing a big battle. Thor and Odin take on Seth in both his normal form and his serpent form. Two different gods with serpent forms, yeah, how original. They ultimately need help to defeat Seth, and it comes in the form of Loki. Once again, fighting for his own interests and survival, he unites with his father and brother to help the cause, though it ends with him and his body being destroyed. After Thor and Odin eventually free the gods and goddesses that Seth trapped, the Asgardians make a deal with the Egyptians to get Loki a working body again. We hope that doesn't deter Loki from helping out like that again, though. Kid Loki. We've mentioned that Loki has bit the dust before, but we wanted to give context to another time that has happened, which turned out okay for a while. Before, Loki has been reincarnated into the body of a woman. However, this time around, he was reincarnated as a small French child. Following his death by the Void while defending Asgard, he manipulated Hela into removing his name from the Book of Hell. That way, he wouldn't truly die. He would just be reincarnated. He returns as a young French boy who's discovered by Thor. He doesn't remember his old self at first, but he has some of his memory and powers restored later on. During this time, he chose to follow down a different path than his normal trickster self. He essentially wanted to be a hero like Thor in the Avengers he had so many negative encounters with. Did this go well for him? Well, he did help out our heroes on more than one occasion. He kept the World Heart hidden from Galactus, and he invaded Asgard and also helped safeguard Midgard. He also did this to spare his brother's life. We just hope this puts Loki into a not annoying child character category, and that list is too short. Helping Wiccan and Hulkling. Eventually, Loki regains control of himself in the kid version of his body, but he still has some of those particularly heroic moments rub off on him. One of the first moments revolves around his interactions with the heroes Wiccan and Hulkling. Wiccan, aka Billy Kaplan, had magical mutant powers manifest after engaging with a bully for picking on his sexuality. This advice to stand up to his bully came from Scarlet Witch. After finding out that the Avengers disbanded and couldn't find a suitable teacher, he was recruited from a list of possible replacements if the Avengers did ever disband. Here he met Hulkling, a combination of two alien races, the Kree and the Skrulls, that gave him enhanced physicality, shapeshifting, and an appearance that resembled the Hulk. During a conflict with the interdimensional being Mother, Loki was given the decision to save both Wiccan and Hulkling from the villain. He doesn't necessarily have to, but he wanted to use Wiccan as a means to get his normal magical powers back. He channels that inner will not be a hero and saves them both from Mother. Although good deeds, he doesn't feel worthy being a part of the Young Avengers, and he leaves the team. Shame, being a hero looks good on Loki. Loki versus Thanos. We all knew Infinity War this past summer was going to be a kill fest for Thanos, but fans weren't expecting Loki, of all of the characters, to be one of the first victims. Within the first 15 minutes of the movie, Loki is choked out by Thanos with no way of fighting back, but we were glad he tried. After surrendering the Tesseract to Thanos, he crushes it to reveal the Space Stone inside. Loki then offers up his assistance to Thanos and his team in an attempt to try to free Thor. He magically summons a blade and strikes for the neck, but Thanos reaches for Loki's neck too. After everything he's been through in his life, we get to see Loki as he truly is, a good-hearted trickster. It looks like even Loki has moments that made his heart grow 3 sizes bigger. Do you think we missed a moment? Who's your favorite friend of Loki's? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe to CBR for more MCU videos just like this one. Thanks for watching. Later.